Welcome back, everybody. My name is Taylor Martin. This is the Best Damn EDC, and today we are talking fixed blades at long last. More specifically, we're talking fixed blades for everyday carry. And a few months ago, I did exclusively that for an entire month. I don't even know what month it was, but for an entire month, and even actually a few weeks before and after that, every cutting task I did was done exclusively with a fixed blade. Whatever one I was carrying on me that day, I did it for all of the food prep at home. Like, even when I was cooking, I didn't even use kitchen knives. I used my EDC blade, whatever it was that day, no matter how big or small. I used my fixed blades for an entire month. And I will say that when I started that month of fixed blade carry, I expected to come out of the whole thing feeling one way, and I definitely felt a totally different way. So that's what this video is all about. I'm going to tell you five reasons why you should consider adding a fixed blade to your everyday carry, four reasons why I think maybe you shouldn't, and I'm also going to talk about all the fixed blades that I carried, some of the caveats with them, and some of the things that I really, really liked about them. And I think at the end, I'll probably tell you what I think my favorite EDC fixed blade is. So with all that said, let's do the damn thing. So I've been toying with this idea of carrying a fixed blade for a long time. I like fixed blades, but I live in a state, North Carolina, where fixed blades are kind of in a gray area. You have to open carry them, you cannot conceal them, and if I'm reading the law correctly, not even a concealed carry permit will allow you to conceal a fixed blade. And it's not really about concealment for me. I don't care if people know I'm carrying a fixed blade or not. It's about staying within the law, but also ease of use, comfort, convenience, and open carry isn't all of those all the time. I don't like a lot of the open carry options. So that's just something that you have to take into account before you even consider adding a fixed blade to your carry. But the first reason that I think you should consider adding a fixed blade to your carry is cleaning couldn't be any easier. It's just one big slab of metal with some handles or scales on it. That's it. You just wipe it down when you're done using it. There's no pivot, there's no bearings, there's nothing else to worry about. Just clean the blade off. And yeah, some fixed blades, a lot of fixed blades, and even folders, not all of them are stainless, so you do have to maintain it in that regard, but cleaning and maintaining a fixed blade is keeping the edge sharp and just wiping the sucker down. There's nothing else to it, and there's some really beautiful simplicity in that, and that was my favorite thing, is just, oh, I got stuff all over the handle and the blade, just wash the thing down, wipe it off, and you're good to go. The second reason is that it's faster to access, right? When you have a folder in your pocket, you have to pull the knife out of your pocket, flip it open, and adjust your grip, unless you're using a wave draw. But most knives don't have a wave, so you have to open the knife and sometimes adjust your grip. It's a three-step process where the fixed blade, you can pull it straight out of your sheath and it's ready to go. Sometimes you don't even have to adjust your grip depending on the knife, such as this right here. This is the TPK mid-size Raptor. When you pull it out of your sheath, wherever you've got it, your grip is already there because you're pulling it out by the handle in the grip that you already need. So this is on your belt, you pull it out, you're ready to cut. That is one of the best things about using a fixed blade. However, there's a giant caveat with that. Putting away a fixed blade can be a little more daunting. You might need to use two hands or watch what you're doing because there's a big pointy tip that doesn't get covered up until it's in the sheath. So depending on how you have it sheathed, whether it's front cross draw, scout carry, in your pocket, whatever it is, you kind of have to look at what you're doing so you don't stab yourself. You can use your finger and kind of feel around to get a knife back in its sheath. On the contrary, with a folder, you close it and throw it in your pocket without much fuss because the tip is covered, the edge is covered. You don't worry about stabbing yourself, but with a fixed blade, sometimes it can get a little tricky, but I did end up carrying some of these so much that I got very comfortable just putting them away by feel and never had any accidents, thankfully. The third reason you should consider a fixed blade for everyday carry, especially if you are a very hard user, you're out in the field and you use your knife a lot, is that fixed blades in general are very, very tough and also in general tougher than their folding counterparts. Yeah, maybe you could crack a scale or something, but generally all you have to be concerned with is the blade itself. No frame lock or liner lock or access lock or any other locking mechanism, pivots or anything. It's just the blade, and that makes them extremely strong. Reason number four is that there are no moving parts, and it's kind of a continuation of the cleaning point and also that they're sturdier. There's less to fail because no moving parts, but there's no places, nooks and crannies that you have to clean out either. But it also comes to when you are maintaining a knife, if you can't take this apart. So with a folder, you might take it apart, put it together, and then you've developed some blade play and you didn't have it before. Some blade centering's off. You don't have to worry about any of that with a fixed blade ever. It's just a chunk of steel with some scales on it and an edge. And reason number five is that there's just something about using a fixed blade that feels great, kind of empowering. And I don't know how to articulate it exactly, and you won't know until you actually use a fixed blade, but there's just something about it that feels maybe a little more secure. I don't know. When I carried a fixed blade before and after that entire month, sometimes I would have another knife with me and I would almost always go for the fixed blade because it just felt better. And it is sometimes more convenient to just grab the fixed blade. You don't have to flip anything open, but there is something about it that just feels awesome. That being said, there are some things about fixed blades that make them less convenient and improbable or impractical for a lot of people. The first reason is that they might be illegal where you are. It doesn't even depend on size in some places. For me, it doesn't matter if I'm carrying something like this Peña fixed clip. This is a tiny fixed blade, but it's a fixed blade. So if I concealed this, that's technically illegal despite its size. There is no length requirement on a fixed blade to be concealed or open carry. It is just a blanket statement. Fixed blades must be open carry. And I would definitely check with your local laws before you buy or carry a fixed blade every day. The second reason you shouldn't consider a fixed blade for EDC comes down to convenience, or rather the inconvenience of a fixed blade. So they do have many, many pros, but there are also some cons, such as folders. You can get a little more bang for your buck as far as cutting edge goes, because you can get a 4-inch blade, fold it shut, and it still slides into your pocket pretty inconspicuously. Whereas if you want a 4-inch fixed blade, this is already a big fixed blade for everyday carrying. This is a Bradford Guardian 3-inch blade. So when it comes to a 4-inch blade, you've got a 4-inch blade, and then you still have to have room for the handle, and that's a lot of big bulk to carry with you every single day. It's not something I would do. I actually trended towards much smaller fixed blades because they're still just as stout, and if you can find one that really fits your hand and fits what you need, they can be actually very convenient to carry. But in general, I would say that fixed blades are less convenient or more inconvenient to carry than folders. Folders were made or created for a reason. They're more convenient to carry with you. They are self-contained. They hide their edge inside the handle rather than having to also have a sheath. That brings me to point number three. Sheaths kind of suck. I've been through a lot of different sheaths. I had an Armitage sheath for the Bradford Guardian 3. It was okay. I just don't like carrying belts on my knife. Belts on my knife. Yep, that's what I don't like. I just don't like carrying knives on my belt, whether it's Scout, whether it's tip up, tip down, cross draw. It's never been extremely comfortable for me. And I carry a Tell of Knives holster on my side a lot, carrying gear in it, but fixed blades for some reason are just less comfortable to carry. And also for me, the sheaths a lot of the time are concealed. These are not for open carry. I cannot open carry this with the pull the dot strap on it. So it poses a big problem for me as far as legal reasons go, and also comfort and convenience. The sheaths are something that I found in a lot of fixed blades are not great. And that one is definitely more personal preference, because a lot of people don't mind this, and it's also legal where you are. But for me, the sheaths do pose a problem. I had to start looking for fixed blades that had these clip sheaths so I can clip them inside my pocket, because in North Carolina, if you have your pocket clip showing, that is not concealed. It's no different than a pocket knife at that point, or a folding knife. You can slide this in your pocket and it's technically open carry, because from my understanding of North Carolina law on knives and concealment, you're not making an attempt to conceal if you have a pocket clip exposed. And that's been actually a much more convenient way for me to carry as well. So not only is it legal, it's also more convenient in my personal opinion. I can take it out, put it in, and there's no fuss. This has been my favorite way to carry a fixed blade, obviously because I have acquired many of these sheaths for my different knives with clips on them. And the fourth reason really comes down to public reaction. This is something that I think a lot of people who are into knives are familiar with. You've come to grips with it. People do react differently when you pull out a knife in person. And it really, when it comes to a fixed blade, it doesn't matter if it's something small like this or the Peña. You carry a fixed blade, and when you pull it out to cut something, if you're in public, you get a reaction from it, regardless of whether you want one or not. And that's really no different from any other knife, especially if it's like a bigger knife, bigger folder. You're always going to kind of get that reaction. But fixed blades, in my experience, have drawn a little bit different attention. I don't really know the reason for that. Maybe they just kind of have a stigma because fixed blades aren't something that people carry a whole lot. From what I can tell, the only thing that you're going to be able to carry and not get a big reaction like that regardless is probably a slip joint or something like a Swiss Army knife. But yeah, you have to expect that. There's just something about that action, just pulling a knife out of a sheath like that. It'll get a reaction just like a big folder. So what it comes down to with EDCing fixed blades is I think a lot of us can agree that there are a lot of pros to fixed blades and a lot of cons, but for everyday carry, I think for a lot of us and a lot of the time, the cons will outweigh the pros just because they can be inconvenient to carry. Legality reasons, there's a lot going against fixed blades, especially for daily carry, but they definitely have a place. And I still like them. I've actually come out of this feeling totally different than how I came into it. All of my experience with fixed blades before this were with belt sheaths that I just could not get on board with. I had actually this. I gave this one a go a while back and tried to open carry it because it was such a big sheath. This is the Travax Trek. And it wasn't for me. It just was not for me. And there have been some that I've carried like this, I carried on my belt. But what I found is that there are certain ways around the inconveniences, and there are certain fixed blades that are really, really good for everyday carry, things that are very convenient. This isn't something that I would take camping. This Pena fixed clip would not take this camping, but this right here was actually one of my favorite knives through this whole thing. It's just a really awesome fixed blade for everyday carry. What I learned is that the sheath is the biggest thing for me, because this right here, like I said earlier, the Topps Bull Trout is such a good knife. I really wanted to carry this more because I love the knife. I hate this sheath. I just despise it for everyday carry. This, again, is something that I'm camping. I probably wouldn't mind throwing this on my hip at all, but for everyday carry, not a chance ever. I need a new sheath for it. Love this blade. The ergos are perfect. It's such a good knife. nearly ruined by a subpar sheath. And I think that's something that I've learned is when you buy a fixed blade and expect to carry it for everyday carry, for me, I've learned that I'm probably also gonna have to buy a sheath for it. And just because I mentioned it, this is the Artemis sheath for the Bradford Guardian 3. So a Kydex sheath, and I have an Ulti clip on here. And the Ulti clip pops open, very, very stout clip, and you can clip this to your pocket. And this sheath or a bag or strap or something, the sheath won't go anywhere. These clips are extremely strong, but I wanted to pocket carry this and these clips shredded my pockets. But my problem with the Ulti clip and the Armatus sheath is that this adds so much bulk to what is otherwise a pretty skinny knife. I mean, the knife comes down right here, but this adds so much width. So I ended up with this. This is a Roque Customs clip sheath, and this has actually saved the Bradford Guardian 3. I was considering selling the Bradford, and I am not now because I really, really love this setup. So it comes down a lot to what sheath it has or what the sheath is like originally and what sheath options are available. Another one that I had and I tried to carry a lot and just couldn't get on board with for everyday carry. This was actually my favorite knife when I went camping. I've still got wood marks on it, but for everyday carry, I couldn't get on board with it because of the sheath. Again, just a Kydex sheath with pull the dots. This is the BMKT or BM Knife and Tool Ember. Love this knife. I still need a better sheath for it. Another BMKT that I carried and really enjoyed is the EDC One, but it was kind of in the same camp as the Ember until I got this Roque Custom sheath. And I hope I'm saying that right. It's R-O-A-C. So I hope it's Roque Customs, but these were made for me by Trevin. He's a really great dude and he does amazing work. And these sheaths have made these knives for me. Another one that I got that has been just wildly popular. I did not like the sheath to begin with this one either. And this is the Giant Mouse Knives GMF1. Really, really great tiny knife. One that definitely needs a lanyard because it's really just a three-finger grip. Love the blade shape. As you know, Yenzanso, Voxnez, like these are really, really ergonomic knives. This one was really good. I didn't like the sheath. And then Oak City Leather Supply from the Discord sent me this one. It's just a little pocket clip sheath. Has been great ever since. I carried this one, I'd say, probably actually the most. After I got the sheath, this is the one I carried the most because it's so slim and thin, like just disappears in the pocket. The other one that I carried a ton was the Pena Fix clip. And this one actually comes with a clip sheath. I think this one's really great out of the gate as an EDC knife. It's really small, very, very slim, and it does come with this sheath, but the problem This one is that it's just unavailable. Really hard to find these, and that's unfortunate. A lot of these are very tough to come by. Another one that I carried a lot is the Tactical Pterodactyl Midsize Raptor. I carried this one for like 2 weeks straight and really liked it. Problem, if you could guess, is the sheath. I don't think the Kydex sheath is bad. It just limits what I'm able to do with it. These pull the dots. If I have to carry it on my belt like this, technically I'm stepping outside the law because this would be covered by whatever shirt I'm wearing. So struggle with this one. I really, really, truly like the knife. It's stout. This is not like a slicey knife. This is much more like a utility knife that you're going to break down boxes with. Very, very thick behind the edge, but it's still a sweet little blade. I will continue to use fixed blades in my carry. I've really actually grown to like it. It's not something I'm going to do all the time because I still enjoy folders a lot, and I think folders are just inherently more convenient. My favorite, it's really tough to pick a favorite. I would say Bradford Guardian 3. It's easy to find. These are constantly in stock, and it's just a really solid shape and size. Just a great knife, and there are lots and lots and lots of sheath options. I think in the near future, I will probably do a video on my favorite EDC fixed blades. Probably going to be getting some different ones and getting rid of some of these. So stay tuned for that. That's it, guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that thumbs up button down below and subscribe to see more stuff like this in the future, and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I upload new videos. If you want to support what I'm doing here, hit the links in the description down below. Those are affiliate links and they help support the show. You can also go to patreon.com/bestmedc or carrycommission.com, which is my store, and you can buy stuff directly from me. And also be sure to follow us around the web. You can find us in most places at bestmedc. With all of that said, and until next time, carry on.